No, kasi I was looking at the, you know, the... I was looking at the... the from the house. And I couldn't find anything that would somehow lower the cost of this initiative. I don't see anything that says tutulungan yung mga kababayan natin na namumroblema sa relationship. If that is the noble intention of the bill, no? So, yun yung isa sa mga talagang weird. For me, pati yung meron pang nakalagay dun na 60... Saan na ba yun? 60 days. 60-day cooling off period. Meron pang ganun eh. I have no idea, and I was looking at the deliberation sa house. It was never raised eh. I wanted to find out what's the basis nung 60 days na cooling off period. 60 days. Baka dapat mas palawakin natin yung pagkakaroon ng marriage counseling services. Diba? Access dito. And yun, marami akong ano, marami akong concerns. And you know, if we're going to debate on it on the floor, why not? I'll be ready. Again, malinaw yung aming posisyon, and I think maraming kasamaan ko dito sa Senado na ang posisyon ay gawing accessible at maging pro-poor itong annulment. Because the way I look at this divorce bill, pro-rich pa rin po ito. Pro-rich pa rin. Oh, definitely. With that absolute divorce bill, easy to decide to absolutely vote no. Yeah, meron, di ba? Meron ba tayo? Mga existing po eh. Yeah, may mga pending. Yeah, we can look into it. Again, yung constitutionality is also a serious concern, no? Article 15, Section 2 of our 1987 Constitution, and I quote, marriage as an inviolable social institution is the foundation of the family, at nakalagay doon, and shall, and let me emphasize the word shall be protected by the state. Laking issue. Sumumpa kami lahat to protect and serve the best interests of our people. Protect our constitution. Thank you. Salamat. Salamat po.